welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie.
Today's topic,
when spirits attack. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that he may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Ephesians 6, 10 through 12. We are living in a day of unprecedented spiritual attacks by the enemy. The spirit of the Antichrist is rising among us and becoming more brazen on a daily basis. The Holy Ghost warns us through Paul's letter to Timothy that these times would come. 1 Timothy 4 speaks of seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And also in 2 Timothy 3, Paul speaks of unholy, evil men and seducers getting worse and worse. We are seeing these things happening all around us. These spiritual attacks are not something new, however. All through the Gospels, we read of spiritual attacks causing some people to act like wild animals, to kill others, and even try to kill themselves. That's not surprising, since we know that the thief has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I firsthand have witnessed spiritual attacks. I remember even when the Lord wanted me to come up higher and get deeper in his word, while the Lord started to reveal to me the mysteries of darkness, I would come under demonic attack, just even by studying the word. I've witnessed demonic attacks throughout my ministry, attacks on my family, attacks on my finances, my health, both physical and mental. I've witnessed spiritual attacks even in my own church. Spirits that try to come there and stop our worship and our praise. There are times it might just be a simple visitor, folks not knowing that the individual is an agent sent by Satan to bind the church and to bring the people's minds into captivity. 1 John 4 verse 1 reminds us that we should try the spirit whether they are of God or not. The Spirit of God does not make you sit and be quiet during worship service. The Spirit of God can cause rocks to cry out in praise and worship. So if the Spirit of God can do that, why would the Lord want you who are lively stones to be sitting down during worship and praise and refuse to even testify? That only happens when you are spiritually oppressed. God never tried to hide the fact of the church that we would be involved in spiritual warfare, but he told us very clearly that we do not fight against flesh and blood, but we are fighting against principalities. God told us again in 2 Corinthians 10 verse 14, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Many times we tend to see an individual rather than to see the devil that is using that individual. There's an old saying that you fight fire with fire. It's the same principle when it comes to the spiritual realm. How do we fight against the spirit? We do so with the power of the Holy Ghost. Our weapons are not carnal, but they're mighty through God. What is God? According to John, God is a spirit. Spirits are attacking people in the world, and spirits are attacking people in the church. What do? We fight back with the Spirit of God. If satanic spirits can attack people, then the Holy Spirit of God can attack people as well. Acts 2 told us, and made them speak in languages they didn't know. The Holy Ghost attacked a man who denied Jesus 3 times and made him lift up his voice and declare, "This is that which was spoken by the prophet." The Holy Ghost attacked the prison and delivered Paul and Silas and saved the jailer and his entire family. If you can believe that satanic spirits can attack people and cause them to do things they wouldn't normally do, then why can't we believe that the Holy Ghost can do the same? Greater is he that is within me than he that is within the world. You need to get this revelation and start praying that the Holy Ghost would attack your family, your neighborhood, your workplace, your city, your town, or even your parish. Jesus said, "Behold, I give unto you power over all the power of the enemy. Whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." We do not have to sit back and let satanic spirit destroy our lives, our families, our cities, our churches begin to bind those satanic spirits that have been attacking you and loose the Holy Ghost to go and attack. The thought of the day, there is no power that can overcome the power of the Holy Ghost. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.